Ladies and gentlemen, this is the Alexander News Show, and I'm Alexander Carlos, and I'm here in the city of Hialeah, the city of progress. I was born and raised in the east side of Hialeah. We're talking 44 years ago, 1977. I'm here with one of the up and coming, because you're still up and coming.
Well, I appreciate it.
Political figures in this town. He's going to be the next mayor of the city of Hialeah, Mr. Esteban Bovo.
How are you doing, Alex?
Thank you very much. I'm doing very good. How are you doing?
Pleasure. My pleasure to be here. I'm glad that we had a chance to meet. I've seen some of your work on social media. I know you're very concerned with the city. And
absolutely. Alexander News Show. Please like and share and hit the bell for notifications and subscribe. But I appreciate your compliment. I'm going to get straight to the point. What is your vision? I know for a fact you're going to be elected mayor of the city of Hialeah. I mean, that's a slam dunk. I know you got to put in some work. You got to grind a little bit. That's like everything you do in life. What's your vision for the city of Hialeah?
Well, first and foremost, I want to make sure that everybody understands that I don't take this race for granted. I respect those that are running for office. I understand the sacrifice that's required to run, not just on the individual, but on the family. So I don't take it for granted. I know that we need to work very hard. So I've been humbled by the support that many people have been showing me. Look, I think Hialeah is in a moment of really true transition. You know, we're seeing so much pressure of development, of investment in the city, perhaps nothing that we've seen over the last 40 to 50 years. So I think it's going to require a steady hand, not only to be able to guide and allow for these investments and developments to come in, but at the same time respect the nature of what many that already live in the city of Hialeah, what they aspire to. You know, I want peace and tranquility in my city.
Absolutely.
But I do want investment. Investment brings opportunities. Investment not only brings jobs, but investments also allow us to keep our taxes for those that live here already at a steady level, while we know that those that are now investing usually pay a higher rate. That leads to better service long term.
Absolutely. Well, I want to ask you just a couple of straight up,
yep,
straight to the point questions that are concerning not only myself as a resident and business owner, by the way, because I'm a special needs therapist.
Good. Oh, cool.
What about the annex area? I see the grass on 97th Avenue. Mm-hmm. I believe it's like West 35th Avenue, if I'm not mistaken. Okay. Grass, like with weeds on the side of the roads and on the main of the road 4 feet up high. No police presence. ATV, there's times that I go by there and it's like no cop, no cars, no police. And ATVs running wild, illegal dumping. How are you going to address this? How are you going to fix this?
Well, I think for the first and foremost, the most important discussion here is that the annex area is really the future of the city of Hialeah. The investments that we're seeing out there, the big industries that are literally planting seeds in the city of Hialeah, like Boeing, like Home Depot, these investments speak loudly about our city. And I think the city needs to not only pay attention, but the city needs to put its money where its mouth is, right? We need to invest in that area.
That's an agreement they made with the county, that part of the agreement, and it's on paper, two police officers at any given time. A fire station.
Yeah.
It's not happening.
Well, I don't know if two is going to be enough, to be perfectly honest with you. I think that should become our new Sector 6 as far as the police station is concerned. We should have a fire presence out there, fire rescue and fire suppression. And I think that the residents out there need it, not just the ones that are already living there, but soon enough, we're going to have even more.
They're building a lot.
Yeah, there's going to be more investment. There's going
to
be apartments out there. Absolutely. And like I said, I think the city needs to have its eye firmly placed on that area for many reasons. Well, number one, you have residents living out there that need service. Number two, the long-term plans of the city involve greatly the annex area. And then I would tell you, you know, I think natural for this conversation is the two bridges, right? The two bridges need to open. As far as I'm concerned, and while I was on the county commission, we worked hard to make sure that 170th would open to give relief to the residents in that area. But I feel the same thing about 154. And what's interesting is that now some of my opponents in this race are talking about opening the bridges when at times They were in favor of putting parks on top of these bridges, which would literally condemn the folks that live out in the annex area to only really one way in, one way out of
the
communities.
So you're for having an open road for those, connecting to Miami Lakes, the town of Miami Lakes?
Yeah, absolutely. The bridges need to open. And, when I was serving in the county commission, I served not just Hialeah, but Miami Lakes. And I had a very honest conversation because I do believe these, we need to be honest with these conversations. The folks in Miami Lakes ultimately are going to want those bridges open so they could get over to the west side because of all the different industries that are going to go out there. You have the restaurants that are going to go out there, the shopping amenities that are going to go out there, you're going to have folks in Miami Lakes that are going to want those bridges open. But for safety purpose alone, those bridges should be open for the residents that live in the annex now. And I think that has to be a priority for that area to make sure we have the connectivity needed.
Okay. Wanted to know, I was at Sparks Park, and I have a video of this on my YouTube channel. Sparks Park and Mylander Park with the JFK Library. I was 2 weeks ago, the grass, the weeds. I mean, I was in North Miami just yesterday, one of the parks. I don't want to compare cities, but I have to in this case, the grass nice and cut, nice and neat. Look, we got, Hialeah's got better parks than a lot of the cities in Dade County. Come on. What's going on here, Mr. Bobo?
Well,
the grass big. No, weeds.
I think, you could always talk
dead
about
dead palm trees.
No, you could always talk about issues of budgeting, right? And do you have enough budget to maintain the parks? I feel that government has certain responsibilities, and those responsibilities are to provide police, fire, garbage pickup, those common areas, parks, for example, to make them and keep them as pristine as possible. That's what you and I pay our property taxes for. What government shouldn't become is an experiment in social services, trying to fix all the issues in our society. We provide basic service, and your budget should reflect the priorities of your government.
Which includes having the grass cut.
Well, obviously, you want parks that are not
with
only
no weeds
pristine,
and no dead palm trees.
You want parks that are pristine and safe. You want programming in your parks just as much as you want police to be able to respond in 2 to 3 minutes.
How about the illegal dumping issue? Solid waste was privatized a few years ago. Do you agree that it should continue to be privatized? Again, look, this is not about me. This is for you, the viewer. Forget about my opinions. My opinions I can say on another show.
Sure.
This is about you.
Yeah.
Are you for the private to continue the privatization of the solid waste department, or no? And how will you fix the illegal dumping issue
look,
in the city?
I think the genuine response is that we have to review. Now we've had privatized garbage, for about 3 or 4 years. So now I think comes the time that we should be able to review how that is working for our residents. I will tell you what I see and what I've heard from some residents as I've gone door to door. There used to be a time that the garbage in my home was picked up before 10 o'clock in the morning. There are instances now where our garbage is not getting picked up till 2, 3, 4, sometimes 6 o'clock in the afternoon. And I would tell you that, what you want as a city with your garbage department is that the streets are picked up and clean by noontime. You don't want garbage lingering in the afternoons. So, I have to look at the contract and see what parameters have been placed in that contract, but obviously what I want is better service. Now, can a private vendor provide it? Perhaps, if the administration is on top of that private vendor. But I remember a time where garbage was picked up very early in the day, and I think that's what many of us got used to. Same thing happens with bulk. Many of us put out our bulk garbage, and depending on your specific day, for me it's the second Thursday of the month, but there has been times where they don't pick it up on Thursday, and they'll come back on a Friday. I've seen instances where they haven't picked it up
on that Friday, and it's gone over the weekend. You mentioned this. I'm glad that you will consider reviewing the whole entire contract and the whole thing.
Yeah.
I remember when Hialeah had its own solid waste department. I've even gone and I've seen the solid waste department inside the public works. And it became privatized, and things are worse, in my opinion, with it being privatized. Look, I believe in privatization.
Mm-hmm.
Public, private, we team up, it's great. But I'm glad you mentioned that you're going to review it. Let me ask you two more questions before we end the Alexander News Show interview. Again, we're with the future mayor of the city of Hialeah, Esteban Bobo. Slam dunk, he's going to win. I know he's going to grind. He's got to grind. but he's going to win. I mean, come on, there's no competition. But so the one thing I wanted to ask you is about the police department. Do you have a police chief in mind right now that you are thinking of putting in?
No, I don't, and I don't want to give anybody any misleading thoughts. We're going to have, and probably the most important decision that I will have, God willing, as mayor in the first 6 or 7 months of my administration, is the selection of a new police chief. And what I want that process to happen is a transparent process. It is an important decision because I would hope that that police chief, he or her, would serve with me as mayor during the duration. I want a professional police department. I want a police department that understands the vocation of service to its community. And what I would hope is that in this process that we go through, that we'll be able to analyze, do we promote someone from within the department to become chief, or do we bring somebody from the outside? And I think what we need to do is just make sure that we go through a process where business leaders, activists in our community, perhaps are part of the process, where we could understand where do we want to take our police force. There's a lot of things going on in policing today. Technology is starting to be a bigger part of our police efforts through cameras, through drones.
Does Hialeah Police Department have a drone?
The Hialeah Police Department now has a drone. Actually, I was participating That's recently great. in some unveiling that we have a command center, a training center for our cops, and we have now drones. And the legislature is opining more and more on how much you could use drones as far as police work is concerned. But I think you want your police department to evolve along with the technology to make it a better police department.
Absolutely. And do you know a lot of potential candidates that are in the Miami-Dade Police Department that would be good for the...
Well, I
not
think...
Not to say that I would want 100% someone from the Miami-Dade Police Force, but I'm just thinking, because they do build some really fine cops there.
Well, I think what... one thing is for sure. Hialeah is the second largest city in Miami-Dade County, sixth largest in the state. The chief of police, the director of the police for the city of Hialeah is an important position. I would assume that once there's an opening and people understand it is a wide open process, that you're going to have a lot of folks, not just statewide, but perhaps even nationally, apply for the police department. And it'll be a daunting task, no doubt about it, but it's a task that I think that we need to be very deliberate in to make sure we do right for our department in the future.
Well, my last question is, East Hialeah, it's going to change. Can you tell me a little bit about your vision for the east side of Hialeah? From 37th Avenue, actually it starts on 35th, in parts of it, all the way to like Palm Avenue.
Palm Avenue, yeah. So look, the East Hialeah, that's like the bedrock, right, of our city. And we've been doing a lot of...
Born and raised here. East 9th Lane, 45th Street.
East side. We've been out there. We've been knocking on doors and talking to the folks. And there's a couple of things that are very interesting that's going on in the east side of Hialeah and the southeast end of the city. Number one is that you're seeing people come in and invest. You're taking old being rebuilt. And that's really, really interesting to see what's going on as far as the east side is concerned. Now, I believe there has to be an investment in new roads in that area. Because one of the things that I have noticed as we've been going door to door is that there are areas where the roads have been updated and fixed, and then there are areas that are still kind of forgotten. And I think, especially for those residents that have lived in Hialeah 40 years, 50 years. I knocked on a door the other day of a resident in Hialeah that's been living in Hialeah, listen to this, living in Hialeah for 60 years.
Wow.
Same house, east side of Hialeah, and very simple ask, fix my roads, because when they get a lot of rain, they get a lot of flooding.
You know that it went through a revolution, like 30 years ago, Hialeah went through a revolution where a lot of the roads got built. Who do you give that, who is responsible for that?
Well, I was on the city council when we were doing a lot of those works back then. So back in the late 90s.
That includes East 10th Avenue, from back when East 10th Avenue was like, that's where it first started. Mm-hmm. Who was credited for most of that?
Well, I think you got, in reality, you would credit the mayor at that time, Raul Martinez, and Julio Rolaina, both kind of like shared in that responsibility. I was on the city council. I was city council president.
You take a little credit for that.
But I think the council in general, we were all collaborating. We understood that the importance and what we see when we do new roads in our city, I think it's something extremely interesting. When you invest in roads, people invest in their homes. And that's something that we were doing really. I got on the council in 98. I got reelected in 99. I want to say that there was not probably a council meeting or a couple of council meetings that we were not approving brand new roads in the city. And you saw the signs of it, you know, in the early 2000s. Yeah. I remember 2003, 2004, 2005, when Julio became mayor, we were still doing roads. It's important. You invest in these roads, and this is the infrastructure needs that we have.
I agree. I'm going to tell you, before we end the show, a really quick story. I don't know if you remember this. I laugh at this all the time. When Raul Martinez mm-hmm. was mayor, he went against Miami County, and he wanted to incorporate the city of Hialeah to become a county.
Well, it's interesting. Hialeah's always kind of been rebellious in that way, right? We had as recent.
It actually got some stream.
I was in the legislature when we were having some of these conversations as a legislative aide back in the mid 90s. I also recall as recent, the current mayor had talked to the city of Miami about maybe collaborating, creating a county between the city of Miami and Hialeah. Look, you know, when it comes to relationships with the county, the state, and the federal government, one of the things that I think is unique about my candidacy for mayor is that I've been able to work in different realms of government in the state and in the county. I have good contacts at the federal level. Many of those that have endorsed my campaign, like Congressman Mauro Diaz-Balart or Senator Marco Rubio, are resources I think.
Governor DeSantis, too.
Governor DeSantis has been not only an endorser, he's been very encouraging of me to run. And I think the mayor needs to have these good relationships for the benefit of our residents. And I'm hoping once elected, we could tap into these sources, not just for money, because that's always important, but other resources that could help us. You know, if there's pilot programs that we could do, bring them to the city of Hialeah. I think our city, I believe, the best years are just ahead for
us. Do you believe, just real quick, I know you got to go, but do you believe that Hialeah could ever merge with another city in the future? I mean, that crazy idea of like a county?
Look, you never know. You know, what could happen in the future,
right?
You know, as the county, as Miami-Dade County's government evolves more and more, you know, you never know if all of Miami-Dade County becomes incorporated in one sense or another. And then there's always an opportunity, perhaps, for the city of Hialeah to next lands. Ultimately, what residents want are better services.
Absolutely.
That's why areas incorporated. The reason you have Miami Lakes, the reason you have Doral, the reason you have Palmetto Bay, Cutler Bay, the reason you have those cities is because there was a want to do better service. When the county fails, that gives an opportunity for cities to grow.
Mr. Esteban Bovo, future City of Hialeah mayor, is right next to me. And I want to say thank you for being on the Alexander News Show.
Absolutely. Let's do it again, okay?
Thank you.